Commuters should expect new hours and new rules when taking ferries to cross the Mississippi River. And for riders of one ferry, the Algiers Canal Street, a new fare may be in the works. WDSU reporter Gina Swanson is live tonight with changes and when they could take effect. Good evening, Gina.
Good evening, Camille. For folks who get off work about this time of night and depend on the ferry to get home come next week, they'll have to make other plans. The ferry won't be operating until midnight. These scale back hours come as the ferry is in transition. And once a new management company is in place, riders will likely have to pay more for the service.
Paying a fare, I wouldn't mind that if that's the difference between having a ferry and not having a ferry.
Henrik Carlson lives in Algiers, and catching the ferry is his preferred way to get from the West Bank to the East Bank.
It's more convenient for me instead of trying to fight the traffic on the bridge.
Carlson says keeping the ferry around is a convenience worth paying for.
I pay a fare, yeah. I used to live in New York, so paying a fare isn't an issue to me.
That's just one of the changes on the horizon for ferry operations. Come Monday, the Algiers ferry will be pedestrian only and have shorter operating hours, from 18 hours a day down to 12.
Well, it's disappointing. Certainly, I know that a number of people count on the ferry coming across just for economic reasons.
The new ferry schedule would run most days from 7:15 to about 6:45, a major inconvenience for some in the hospitality industry.
I work late hours on Bourbon Street, catching the last one over. I can't think of what this might do to the service industry, the repercussions in the service industry.
This is New Orleans. This is a night city. What do you expect? People come out here at night.
The changes come as the ferry service is in transition from the state to a local entity, possibly the RTA, but that deal is still in negotiations. In the meantime, the state is using $1.5 million approved in the last legislative session to keep the ferry going. But moving forward, another funding source will be needed. For now, riders we talk to say it's better to have reduced ferry service than none at all.
I don't like the traffic coming back to on the West Bank, and I take the ferry because it's so much, it's not as stressful.
So again, shortened hours here at the Algiers Ferry. Hours for the Chalmette Ferry remain unchanged, and as of July 1st, the Gretna Ferry will cease operations. That's it for now. We're on your side in Algiers. I'm Gina Swanson. Back to you.
All right, Gina, and we should add, the Algiers Canal Ferry will extend its hours on the 4th of July holiday from 7:15 a.m. to 10:15 p.m. to accommodate those who want to participate in the 4th of July festivities.